Hello everyone, I am now just going to show you that how you can add subjective type of questions into our examination module. First you have to come into our web.wasm platform and you can find in the left hand panel there is an examination option is there, the module is showing over here. If you click on the examination, the sub menus will open. You can see on the third sub menu says that add subjective questions. You can click on the add subjective question option. We'll be at this page. Now you can see with question number one that has been stated over here. Parallel to this, there is a drop down arrow. If you click on this drop down arrow, an editor will open up just like an Word or else just like a text editor like this. And this is as same as Word document, so you can add any textual question, you can insert any sort of image question, any sort of code, any sort of table format, tabular format questions, any sort of special character. Like if I click on the special character, you can see these are the options of the special character, mathematics symbols, so all these symbols and all these things can be added. Okay, so just for to give you an example, I am adding a textual question here. If you add a textual question, so definitely there that will be a subjective one, so student will give. Now this is question number one I have added. In a similar way, you can click on this button to add as many as questions you want. Like if I click on this add new option, there will be another same thing will open up with a denotation of question number two, like this question number three, like this question number four. So once you have added the question, you need to click on this save button. Click on this save button. So a pop-up message will run that question added successfully. How you can find and what are the steps that's to be need fulfill after adding the question? First of all, you come on to this first sub menu, that is the question option. If I click on this question option, you can see we'll be on the question repository page, where first of all you will be seeing if you have made any multiple choice question, and then you gradually have to come down at the below of the page where you can find the subjective questions, or else you can directly click on this filter option and select the date on which date you have added the question. Like today is 14th of September, so I am selecting 14th of September. So on 14th of September only one question has added, like explain what is photosynthesis. Now there are a lot other options. Like first of all, you can click on this allow copy paste option. If you want your students to copy and paste from any other source, they can do. If you click check this box out, if not, that means they cannot do. Yes or no. Allow file upload, yes or no. Blank means no. Click checked means yes. So you are allowing your students to upload any external file, like they have written down in the pen and in the paper with pen and they have clicked the photo and uploaded the file. They can write it in the Word file and they have made it and they can attach that Word file. So any external file you can give here. Now the third option is word limit. If you have not given allow file upload, that means they have to come into the app and they have to type the answers. So in that case you have to give your word limit, like whatever the words that you want you can give in word limit. You can define the score of this particular question. You can define the score of this particular question, like is this a 10 marks question or 8 marks question or 5 mark question. Whatever the score that you have decided, you can decide. So all things has been done and you simply added the question. So this is how you are manually adding the questions. So I guess everything clear. If any confusion is there, please be in touch with our awesome help text number at any point of time. Thank you.